Those are the doors from one of your galleries?
Yeah, it was, I did that show at Best Number Playground last, or 2 years ago, that was like,
Bunnies aren't just a design on a door. It's a way to identify this artist. Meet Jeremy Fish.
And I used it for tons of shit. Like in art school, it was my theme. It became like my identity, kind of. Like I made stickers and we pasted posters and climbed up on people's buildings and spray painted little characters and like, not necessarily on some graffiti or street art, just like I was in art school and I was experimenting and like, I had always kind of played with graffiti and it was cool. Then instead of being like, oh, my tag is like, awesome guy one, it was more like my tag is this fictitious gang of maybe 10 people at that time, you know, and that in turn created a lot of interest and curiosity, and through skateboarding and through art school and through all the people I met out here, now the gang was expanding.
And expand it has. Jeremy is involved in all types of projects, making him versatile and allowing him to perfect his ability to mesh creepy with cute.
Like I'll balance the commercial projects to like pay my rent, because fine art's kind of slow right now. Like, paintings aren't selling like they did a few years ago. It's just like, the economy's fucked up. And so yeah, you kind of have to do lots of different things. Like my friends that kind of are very stoic, like, no, I'm a painter, this is all I do, they're fucking working day jobs right now. Because they're so stoic and so set in what they do, and a lot of it's ability and skill level.
He's involved in everything, from doing a mural in Chef Chris Constantino's restaurant in Hayes Valley, skateboard graphics with Mike Giant and those affiliated with Upper Playground and 5024 SF Gallery in Lower Haight, music videos with hip-hop artist Aesop Rock, and even Robin Williams wore his t-shirt during the Giants playoffs.
So how do you maintain so many different projects?
Like, I'll have a year of being very serious and like staying home in the studio and working very diligently on the major projects. And then the alternate year, I'll do a lot of smaller shows and travel around again.
Is traveling a big part?
You need to travel and like meet new people and see new cities and realize that you're actually, like, people are paying attention. You know, I think the nicest thing I got out of this year was like, people are paying attention, you know what I mean? Like, if you just stay in your own little world or in your own neighborhood, or you show in just New York, LA, and San Francisco, sure, there's big crowds at your shows and you'll think, oh, I'm doing really well, but you don't realize the impact of what you're doing until you're in fucking Warsaw, Poland. And there's a bunch of people that know what you're doing. You know what I mean? And then you're like, fuck, this must be really working. Like, and not working on a level where I'm rich. I mean, look, I live in a basement, but like working on a level where I've done this for almost 10 years and the investments are starting to come back to me in ways I never imagined. And again, that isn't lucrative or financial necessarily, although I'm doing better than I was a couple years ago. But like, it's more just like the realizations that if you put 10 years into something, the things that come back to you, you don't see right away. And a lot of what's going on now is like, without traveling, without going to these other cities and seeing and doing all this stuff, aside from the fun and the inspiration I get out of it, it's a nice pat on the back to remind yourself that like, it is working. People do give a shit. And, you know, further you get from home, when you find somebody that's familiar with what you're doing, it's like a real like nice reminder to keep doing it, you know?
To learn more about Mr. Jeremy Fish, visit sillypigbunnies.com. For sale inquiries, please visit Upper Playground in Lower Haight in San Francisco. For online sales, check out umbrellamarket.com.